Okay, so let's start with palettes. I'm getting rid of the Valentine palette Scarlet. I really like this one. I got it, but I have hardly reached for it at all. I have so many palettes. It's a beautiful palette, lots of pinks and reds in there, but I have other palettes that have those colors in there, and that one just seemed to be very repetitive. So even though I did like it a lot, I'm going to get rid of it. I'm getting rid of the NYX Ignite. I think I've had this in another video before, but this is the NYX Ignite one. I swear I'm never buying another NYX palette as long as I live, unless they come out and they say that they have a hugely different formula. This is the NYX Swear By It palette. I cannot get those to have hardly any pigment in them, and they just fall short for me. So I'm not going to buy any more NYX eyeshadows. I'm getting rid of the Perception palette from ColourPop just because, again, the situation where I don't reach for it. And I've had this for at least a year, and I think I've only used it one time. And even though I keep thinking to myself, I'm going to go back and I'm going to reach for it, I really never do. So I'm getting rid of that one. I'm also getting rid of the Yes Please from ColourPop. This one is their best-selling palette ever. But I find that for me, the colors are just too orange, too warm, too stark. And again, this is another one that I don't reach for. I think I've done a couple of looks out of it, and I just don't reach for it. So the next one is a knockoff that I got off of, this is from Beauty Glazed. It's supposed to be a knockoff of the Huda New Nudes palette, and I was going to do a comparison with it. When I looked at the ingredients, I wasn't really happy about it, and it really wasn't a dupe for it 100%. So I did swatch that, but I didn't use it, and I'm not going to. I'm also going to be getting rid of the Too Faced Shadow Insurance. I don't like this one. It doesn't do anything for my eyes. That's absolutely spectacular, and I find that my eyeshadow does crease sometimes with it, so I'm not going to be using that one. This one is from Becca, and I can't remember what this one's called. This is the Soft Light Blurring Powder, and I don't like this. It makes me way too cakey. I don't know why. I don't know if there's something in there that just doesn't work really well. Even my daughter tried it. She's 22, excuse me. She's 22, and she didn't even like it. I'm getting rid of the Jouer Essential Full Coverage Foundation. I even tried this two more times right before I decided to put it in here because I'm like, I need to give this another try. I find that when I use this, it just makes the texture on my face stand out so bad, and it wears horrible on me. And I don't know whether it's just because I have really, really dry skin or what, but I can't do that. It's really hard. I bought these and I was going to review them for you guys, and I put them in products that I didn't like. These are the stamps for the winged eyeliner. One is a right and one is a left. You get two. Could not make this work, so I'm going to get rid of that one. This one is the Monsieur Big Mascara from Lancome. I like the regular formula, but this one is the waterproof formula. And I did like this the first time I used it. As a matter of fact, I used it at my daughter's wedding because I knew I was going to cry. But definitely after that, I just couldn't get it to work. I don't know if it dried out on me. I didn't use it soon enough or what. I went back in like 3 weeks later and just really couldn't get that to work anymore for me. This is a single of the NARS eyeshadow. And even though this is a pretty kind of a golden taupe color, it is pretty, but I just don't reach for it at all. So I'm going to be getting rid of that. I'm getting rid of two of the J.Cat Glow Baked Highlighters. These are some of the driest highlighters I've ever used. You probably could mix something with them, like a cream or something, and make a cream highlighter, but I have so many that I'm not interested in doing that. From Makeup Revolution, I so wanted to like these because I love Makeup Revolution's palettes, but these were just not good. There is a waterproof and a regular mascara here. They need to make their wand or their stopper inside of the mascara so that the wand comes out with less product, because it was so goopy that by the time, you know, I was trying to wipe it off, made a mess there. And then if I just went in, you would immediately just get a goopy, clumpy mess. So I was really hopeful for that one, but it didn't work out. Speaking of Revolution, I'm also not really crazy about their skincare line. They were kind enough to send me all of their skincare line, but you guys, I just couldn't get on board with it because after I researched the ingredients, they weren't that great. And there was other things in there that I just don't really want on my skin. Does that make sense? And the one that I did try, it really didn't do anything. The other thing that really is hard when I look at a skincare and it says something like what this one says about stabilized active collagen, the collagen molecule is too big to penetrate our skin. So when I see something like this, I just kind of just roll my eyes and go, I wish everybody knew that. From Coda Lee, this one is their Beauty Elixir, soothing and glowing complexion. I could not get past the smell on this. It was so nasty that I don't even dare open this. It just really, it kind of made me a little bit sick. These are two foundations that I've had in my collection for a long time. They're in the old packaging even. This is from Wonder 2 Cosmetics, and this is called Coverproof Foundation. This is a good foundation, you guys, but this has been in my collection for way too long. I have it in light, and then I have it in medium, and I do like this very, very much, and I used a lot of it, but when I got to, you know, opening my drawer for the summertime this year, I realized that these have been in the back of my drawer for a while, and they're just too old. I got to get rid of them. I have a couple of loose pigments. This one is the gold one from Too Faced, and then this one is from L'Oreal. It's the Infallible Magic Pigments. This one turns from a powder to a cream as you're putting it on. Great concept. Couldn't quite get on board with what the actual application was. It wasn't as nice as I thought it would be. When you swatch it, it's great, but when it gets on your eyes, it's not that good. And then when you use these gold pure pigments, it makes a really big mess. Plus, this one was just a little bit too stark for me. I probably will never use that color gold, so I'm getting rid of that. From Amazing Cosmetics is this little tube of cream concealer that I got somewhere that I was going to try, but this creased so bad on me, so I'm going to declutter that one. This one is from Estee Edit. Anybody remember when that was a brand? This was a good concept. In the top, you had a cream product, a little mirror in there, which you don't really need because I don't know if I'd put my eye makeup on with that little mirror. And then in the bottom, you have a loose powder, and they are coordinating, and it's a really great concept as far as how pretty they are. This has just been in my collection too long, so it's time to declutter. From ColourPop, this is one of their loose eyeshadow pigments. Even though this is a gorgeous pigment, it has a little bit too much glitter in it for me, and I found a lot of fallout from it. So I'm going to be decluttering that one. From Lorac, I have a little bronzer that is just very orange on me, so I'm decluttering that one. Oh, I missed a palette, you guys. I'm decluttering the Maybelline Soda Pop palette. I did like this. However, I just find again that I'm not reaching for it at all. Also from Makeup Revolution, this is their High Impact Opulence palette, which is basically just a whole lot of shimmers of like gold and champagne and copper colors. Did not look really good on my skin. That's the only reason I'm decluttering it. I do have another one that is more along the lines of the pink colors, and I do like it a lot, so I am keeping that one. Don't anybody say anything. This I have tried so hard to love. This is the Too Faced Peach Perfect Comfort Matte Foundation. There are so many people that says that this is their Ride or Die Foundation. I don't know whether I'm weird or not, or whether it's just because I have super dry skin. This did not work. I couldn't make it work. I couldn't make it look pretty. I'm not happy with that one at all. I'm decluttering a Makeup Revolution Baked Blusher. I'm only decluttering that one because it just really isn't one that I reach for at all. I'm decluttering the NYX Liquid Suede. This is Crystal Metallized or something like that is the color. I'm decluttering that. And I have a ton of nail polishes that have just gotten too old that I'm going to go ahead and declutter as well. From ColourPop, this is a liquid eyeshadow. I find that this wears off way too fast, so I've got flaking on my eyeshadow. This is so pretty. I really love the color of it, but I find that I've got flaking off of my eyes way too fast through the day, so I'm getting rid of that one. This is supposed to be a lash extension mascara that I got off of Amazon. It did not do what it said it was going to do. Another ColourPop eyeshadow. Some more of these nail polishes. I have a ton of nail polishes that I'm getting rid of. The L'Oreal Infallible Metallic Single. I don't mind this one. I think it's quite pretty. I actually got it because of Toddy's recommendation one time, but I just find that I don't reach for it that much. And boy, these shadows are looking pretty on my hand, but they don't perform like that. So you know what? That's why I'm getting rid of them. From Wet n Wild, this is one of their liquid eyeshadows as well. This one flaked too. It was really not good at all. This is a JCAT Beauty liquid eyeshadow. That one didn't work for me. This is a lipstick that I can't remember where I got it, but when I roll it up, I'm like, I am never gonna wear that chocolate cherry deep dark plum colors. So that one is going. A Rimmel lipstick that is just super uber bright coral pink, and I probably will never wear that one, so I'm getting rid of that one. I'm getting rid of my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer because it's just too old, along with the same thing on a couple of my Makeup Revolution Conceal and Defines. I do like both of those, but they're just too old. Lash Paradise Mascara. I don't like this mascara. I have not liked this mascara since I started using it. It's just not one of those that I pick up, so I'm getting rid of that one. I'm also decluttering a Catrice 18 Hour Eyeliner in black, and the only reason I'm decluttering this one is because I have a lot of other ones, and this one you can't get anymore. I guess it's been discontinued, so even though I do like it, I'm getting rid of it because I can't show it on camera anyway. I'm getting rid of my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation because this is too old as well. I'm getting rid of a couple of the matte glosses from NYX that just don't work well on my lips anymore. I'm getting rid of a perfume. This is Euphoria Deep. I love the regular Euphoria, but this one was just a little bit too intense for me. I'm also getting rid of this Jelly Much color from ColourPop. I really like these. These are really good eyeshadows. However, this bright teal green, it just doesn't look good on me, and it's hard to work with up here. It's nice to work with on your eyelids or underneath your eyes, but this one just, it just fell short, so I'm getting rid of that one. This is a Rimmel Art Metallics. I'm getting rid of that one, been there too long. A Sigma eyeliner that has been there too long. This is from L'Oreal, a True Match Concealer. This one didn't conceal for me, so that one's going. From Sephora Collection, this is one of their eyeliners, and it's just old, it needs to go. I'm getting rid of a Tarte Shape Tape and a Rimmel Stay Matte concealers that just don't work for me. They're super duper dry. I'm also getting rid of an Anastasia Beverly Hills Very Nude Color lip gloss. I love these lip glosses. I even put them in my recommendations, but this one is like so pale that it actually is lighter than my light skin, so that's saying a lot. Then from Jouer, I actually did get one of their metallic liquid lipstick sets in the holidays, and this color was just too dark. It's just really, really dark. Even when you put it on, since it is a liquid lipstick, it even gets darker. So that one's got to go as well. I'm getting rid of a bunch of brushes that I just never use them. So this one, these two right here are from Luxie. They're fluffy brushes. And then this is a angled brush. And then this one is from Bare Minerals. You know, it's got a flat end on there, but I don't use these for my foundation. This is an It brush. It's really old for brows. And then this one is from ColourPop, a fluffy brush that just wasn't cut well. And then this one right here is a Morphe, and it's just, I would never use that for anything specific. I'm also getting rid of this It brush. Even though I am a huge fan of It brushes, this one's gotta go. It's domed and it just puts down too much product. So unless I was a person that would use a ton of mineral makeup, this one really wouldn't be a good one because it's really just a buffing brush. Okay, I'm gonna put my glasses on for the last of these so I can go through it fairly fast. From ColourPop, one of their satin lipsticks. I don't like that, it's too dry. From Ulta Beauty, this is one of their cream eyeshadows. It's called Opal. Beautiful color, but I find that the cream doesn't last and it creases really bad. From JCat Beauty, this is one of their Prismetal eyeshadows. Love the color on this one. It was a pretty purple, but it didn't stay on and it flaked like crazy. From Butter London, this is the Glazing Lustrous Liner. This one really made a mess and got everywhere. This is the Lash Domination from Bare Minerals. Couldn't build any lashes with that one. This is from NYX. It's called their Slip Tease. I think they came out for this in the winter and it was okay, but the color was really bad on me and I don't like it. And then does anybody remember these little teeny lip glosses that we got in sets? I don't even remember how long ago at Ulta. I loved getting these because you got to try so many different colors, but at the same time, it just is too old and it needs to go. That's it. That's all of them, you guys, I think. Yeah. So that is everything for today's video. I hope that you did enjoy it. Please give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy it. And don't forget to subscribe if you're new to my channel. We'd love to have you with us. Thank you guys so very much for spending part of your day with me. I hope that it is a wonderful day. And I will see you guys all in my very next video. Take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.